In the last video, we came up with a formula to convert from a mixed number to an improper fraction. So let's apply that formula here with the number 2 and 4 over 5. So we start by taking the 2 out front and multiplying by the 5. So 2 times 5, that's going to give me 10. Then we add the fraction that was already in the top, the 4, so plus 4. And then all over, we put it all over the 5, which is originally there. So this is 2 times 5 is 10 plus 4, and that's all divided by 5, and that leaves us with 14 over 5, and that's our final answer. Let's apply that formula one more time with 4 and 3 over 5. So again, we start with the 4 out front times the 5, that was the denominator originally. Then we add the 3 that was out there already. So 4 times 5 is going to give us 20, plus 3 is 23. So I'll first write down the 5 that was in the bottom, and then the 4 times 5 gives us the 20, plus the 3, 5 carries over, and we're left with 23 over 5. And there's our final answer. Let's look at converting this improper fraction, 17 divided by 5, to a mixed number. So the first thing we need to do is 17 divided by 5. So I'll do this one using the long division method. So we put the 17 underneath and we're dividing it by 5. So how many times does 5 go into 17? It goes into 3 times total. And if we do 5 threes, that's a total of 15. So our remainder here after we subtract is a remainder of 2. So this here, the 3, becomes our whole number out front. And then for the mixed number, the 2 that was the remainder becomes the numerator, and then the 5 that we were dividing by originally becomes the bottom. So this is our mixed number. Let's convert another improper fraction, in this case 47 divided by 6, to a mixed number. But this time I'm not going to use the long division method exactly. We'll just kind of talk it through. So first thing we want to do is figure out how many times does 6 go into 47. So there's lots of different ways you can do this. You can count it out by 6s, or if you know some multiples, like you can start at 36. You know, 36 times 6 is 36, and if we go one more, that's 42. One more after that is 48. So 48 is too high, so that means we have to take 42. So 42 was equal to 7 sixes, right? We started it with 6 times 6 was 36, did one more 6 to get 7. So that gives us the whole number portion, the 7. So now if we take the 47 and we subtract the 42, we get 5. And this here is our remainder. I'll just call it with a capital R. So that means our number out front is the 7. Our remainder goes in the numerator, the 5, and the 6, the original denominator, carries over. So here's us converting to a mixed number without using explicitly the long division method.